Something always brings me back to you. It never takes too long.
This is my sister Mallory. She's danced ballet since she was 4. So it's 10 years of ballet. This is her belly one. So we'll turn around. And this is how she does it. So stay tuned and I'll get right to the tutorial. Alright, hi guys. I'm Mallory. So I'm just going to start with my bun. So what I like to do is I like to have like a spray water bottle. It's like a detangler bottle, but I fill it with water. I like to spray it all over my head. And what that does is just kind of like makes it easier for you to sculpt that bun, like for you to sculpt the bun in the back. It's just going to be a bow with like a side part on the left side. And it's like a low bun. And I feel like it just makes it look a little bit better. I'm making it kind of wet. So like that. And then I just take a comb like this. It's just kind of a thin tooth comb. And then just brush that through my hair to make sure that all the water is distributed. Get a little bit more. Okay, that's that. And then it's already part on the left side. It's like the part's like that. It's not like all the way back. It's just kind of 3/4 of the way in your head. And then I take my hair and bring it to the back, sort of like to the base of your neck. It's almost a little bit above. And then I take my comb again, brush that back, make it smooth, make it look pretty. You do there. And then I just take a ponytail holder and then secure it in the back. And then in the back, then you just want to hairspray it. I'm just using Tresemme hairspray, but whatever's fine. I'm just going to spray that all over my hair, just like that, and then kind of mold it down a little bit. And you can even use your comb to make it look a little bit more neat. And then I just look at that in the back, just like a low ponytail. And then I like to take the water again and spray my ponytail. And then I start to like twist the ponytail on the back. And I'm almost like twisting it into almost like this little rope kind of thing. Just twist it all the way down. And twist it like around your fingers. Twist it around your fingers and around that ponytail holder. And that gives it that just like this nice shape. Then I take another ponytail holder and secure it. Alright, and then I like to take a hairnet. Okay, I like to take a hairnet, just like this, and put that around the bun. And that just secures all the little hairs in place to make sure that it's smooth and just looks nicer. And then I take my bobby pins. This one's like this, doesn't really matter. So I take those. And I like to like kind of put them in like differently, not just like straight in. I'm showing my with my hand. I like put them in like sort of halfway in, and then I put it that way, like goes in, and then I put it to the side. So it just kind of secures the bun better. So I like to do that and put that under. Get some more here, and then down. It's not gonna be perfect, but you guys get the idea.
How many pins do you usually use?
I use about probably 4 to 5 pins. It just depends on the day, because my hair sometimes doesn't cooperate. So it just depends. And then I feel like this is kind of plain for me. I don't like to wear it like this. That's just my opinion. So I like just kind of like put like a little rose in it, just something like that. And just kind of pretty, and I kind of poke the hole through the base and put a bobby pin in there. And I like to put it like on the opposite side of where my part is, because my part's on the left. I'm going to put it on like the bun on the right. I just put it near the top on the right, put that in, and it just makes it look a little bit more pretty. And that's just what I like to do. And then just make sure all the hairs are in place and they're smoothed down and nice. So that's just how to do like a simple bun for dance or whatever or anything.
Something always brings me back to you.